I realized I used the word differentiable to describe a function I didn't technically explain to you what differentiable means, so here's the definition. A function is differentiable at a point A if the derivative exists. I'm sure you guys figured that out. The other thing is that we can talk about differentiability on an interval, an open interval always, right? Because the derivative is something we're talking about going from both sides, so we want it to be an open interval. A function is differentiable on an open interval AB if the derivative exists at every point in the interval. So, for example, for that example that we had in a previous video where it was discontinuous, you would say, for example, that the function was differentiable on the open interval minus 1, 1, because it was 0 there, etc. Now, I do want to point out that the AB also, A could be negative infinity, B could be positive infinity, so it could be differentiable everywhere or on part of the real line or whatever. Okay. Now, one of the things I wanted to point out, this is a very important theorem about differentiability and continuity, okay? If F is differentiable at a point A, then F is continuous there. So it's continuous at the point X equals A as well. Because we remember continuity also is defined similarly in that continuity is defined at a point. So differentiability, they do have this sort of, there is some relationship. Okay, if the function is differentiable, then it has to be continuous. However, differentiability is a stronger condition than continuity. It is a stronger smoothness condition, right? Because we said that in the last video. If the function can be continuous, but the function may not be differentiable. Those were all those examples. So be careful with this theorem, because it doesn't go both ways, okay? In other words, differentiability implies continuity. Continuity does not imply differentiability. And our example of that is differentiability, anything with a cusp or a corner, right? So y equals absolute value of x is the one we actually worked out in detail. But anything, we had another one where you saw we couldn't define the derivative when there was a cusp or a corner. Even though those functions were continuous, you could draw them without picking your pencil up off the paper, but you couldn't get very far in terms of the derivative when we took the derivative. Even formally when we took the derivative, we were able to show that those limits didn't exist. So it's sort of important to know that oftentimes when we think about a theorem going one way, we don't, you know, a lot of theorems are if and only if statements. This is an important theorem that is not an if and only if statement. It only goes that one way. So, if you were interested in the proof of this theorem, I'll put that in the extra materials for the week. Okay. So, one thing that now comes up to mind is, okay, so now that we know that if a function is differentiable, then it is continuous, what kind of things can go wrong with a function where it may not be differentiable, right? So we, of course, saw some of those. Well, we saw one already. We saw it could have a cusp or a corner. So we'll start out with that. So there aren't that many things to look for. There's more to look for than with continuity, right? So how can a function fail to be differentiable, now from a graphical standpoint, I mean, of course, we know from an algebraic standpoint, well, we can't find the limit. Okay, but we're not going to be necessarily looking at the limit all the time, right? In fact, a lot of us don't really like those problems, which a lot of you, maybe I like them, but you know, it's just me. I'm really approaching this more from a graphical standpoint than from a algebraic standpoint. So if I'm looking at the graph of a function, what can I look at and what can I see in that graph that's going to tell me, okay, this function is not differentiable at that point? So one thing that we already talked about is a corner or a cusp. So a cusp, something more like that, pointier than a corner, maybe something like that, whatever. It doesn't matter if it's pointy or less pointy, as close as, and when it's meeting in a way where you can see that you have two different slopes, then you're going to have a situation where the derivative doesn't exist. Secondly, from what we said before, you might actually have a discontinuity. So if a function is we just had this theorem said that if a function is differentiable, then it is continuous. If I look at the contrapositive statement, right, remember, a contrapositive is logically equivalent to the original statement, that's going to tell me that if a function is discontinuous, then the derivative doesn't exist. So, discontinuity. And that could be any kind of discontinuity. Jump discontinuity, the vertical asymptote, whatever. Those situations I'm not going to have a derivative that exists. The third one, which is a little bit more unusual, is a vertical tangent. So I'll have to tell you what that is. I'm going to illustrate with a function. My function is going to be the cube root of x. That's a great function for this. Definitely go and look at this on Desmos or a graphing calculator. And what you'll see is that at zero, so I should put at x equals zero, at zero, this gets super flat. And this is kind of painful to do with the definition of the derivative because you have a cube root, so it's really ugly. So I'm not going to do it or ask you to do it. We'll learn how to do this the other way, and it's pretty straightforward. But with the definition of the derivative, this is no fun. So I'm just going to kind of discuss what's going on here. What happens if I look at the slopes is that they get progressively more and more and more steep here, right? So, in fact, this function gets so flat and vertical here, even though it's actually defined everywhere, so it's not actually vertical. But basically, if I look at the derivative is going off to infinity at the point x equals zero. So it's the function itself is defined fine at x equals zero. If I were to graph the derivative, though, the derivative has an asymptote, okay? So what do we say? Function gets so close to vertical that the derivative has a vertical asymptote. Okay. I should write out the word asymptote, right? I don't know if it's still on the screen. Oh, close. Anyhow, so in fact, if you look at the graph of the derivative here, it actually does look like that. It looks something like this. Okay. We'll get to that. Well, maybe we'll talk about that now, right? Because if you sort of just visually think about what's going on here, these are these different slopes are just getting higher and higher and higher. And that's really going to happen. How do we look at a graph and see that? You don't necessarily know, but I'll try to see. I put a little dotted line in there. I think that Stuart does that as well. At any rate, he used to. Where if it's going up to infinity, either like that or like this, he'll put like a little dotted line there, or it could be something like this, something really flat. So the dotted line is supposed to indicate that there is a vertical tangent. In other words, your function is just getting super flat at that point.